Hello all, let us start with unit number 5 and subsequently then unit number 6. The fifth unit is now combination. It is of rectilinear and curvilinear motion. Both of the kinematics are combined. So let us start with kinematics of particles. Now when we start with all this, as I told you, as per the Newton's second law, force mathematically can be written as force is equal to mass into acceleration. So whenever there is a motion, mass into acceleration is there. But if there is no motion, that itself indicates either the force is zero, I mean to say the resultant force acting on a body, or the acceleration is zero. Okay. So F is equal to zero, no motion. But when motion, there is F equal to ma. This is the basic difference of dynamics and statics. In statics, we can say that no motion without acceleration, or we can say body is at rest, that is no resultant force, or motion of a body without acceleration, is it possible? No. So we are saying there is no motion. Why? Because no acceleration. That is what statics is. Whereas dynamics, we can say motion with acceleration, or whenever there is a R is not zero, F is not zero, there is motion of the body due to the combined effect of the accelerations. So this motion may be with considering the forces causing the motion, or it is without considering the forces causing the motion. So if we talk about without considering the forces and masses causing motion, it is kinematics. But if I consider the forces causing the motion, it is kinetics. That is the basic difference between them. Here again, kinematics can be divided in these parts. This is now your syllabus of unit number 5 combined. That is, kinematics can be motion along horizontal direction, motion along vertical direction, variable acceleration, XT, VT, AT diagrams, that is displacement versus time, velocity versus time, acceleration versus time diagram, and relative velocity, which is not now in your syllabus. Whereas another part of this unit was motion of or motion on curves and projectile motion. So that we'll see one by one. If I start with rectilinear motion, or it can be a linear motion. So if I talk about rectilinear motion, it is the motion along a line is linear motion. But motion along a straight line is rectilinear motion. That is what we have studied up till now. That I will not say wrong, but more correctly, it is motion under only one acceleration. That is motion without change in direction. Suppose on the surface of the earth, if the car is moving along a straight line or along a line, there are two accelerations, tangential and one is the normal acceleration. This normal acceleration is acting toward the center of the earth, where radius of the earth is 6400 kilometers. So if say it is moving with some velocity, I can say AT and AN are the two tangential and normal accelerations. If I say AN is V square by R, ab ye kahan se aaya? If I ask you what is centrifugal force, you immediately say M V square by rho or R. What is that V square by R? That is nothing but the normal acceleration. So now if I say radius of the earth is 6400 into 10 raised to 3, kilometer ko meter mein convert kiya, then 1 by r comes out to be 0.6 times 0, 1, that is 0.156 into 10 raised to minus 8. So to bring an nearly equal to point, rather I will say it is 0.001 lane ke liye bhi, I have to put the velocity almost 100 meter per second, that is 360 kilometers per hour, which is not possible for the vehicle. That can be velocity of aeroplanes. At that case, AN will be zero. And being AN is zero, here this is considered as the motion along a straight line, and that is tangential acceleration. If I ask you equations of motion, that is equations of kinematics, you immediately say V is U plus AT, S is UT plus half AT square, and V square is U square plus twice AS. Remember, here all A are the tangential accelerations. Okay.